So thank you very much. As introduced, Cosmas Sakala, the Deputy Secretary General and the Head of Programs at Zambia Red Cross Society. Without further ado, I just go straight into my presentation that's looking at our implementation of the WASH pillar in the National Multisectoral Coordination Plan. And just to begin with, I'd like to make mention that Zambia Red Cross Society, it's an auxiliary organization to government in the humanitarian sector, which was established by Act of Parliament to augment efforts of government in alleviating suffering, which can come in different forms, including epidemics. We have the presence, our presence in the 55 districts across the country in the 10 provinces, with a network of approximately 5,000 volunteers, which makes it easier to reach the last mile population in service delivery. And I wish also to make mention that the Zambia Red Cross Society has experience in working with cholera preparedness, prevention and control, and working in collaboration with Ministry of Health and other actors, and as can be testified in the 2017 and 2018 cholera outbreak in the country. On the Zambia Red Cross Red Crescent preparedness, specifically mentioning about Zambia Red Cross Society preparedness and response in alignment with the GTFCC, is that as Eria mentioned, that we have a network of volunteers that are across the country scattered in where cases normally come from. We are the hotspots are inclusive. And the one of the critical strategy that the Zambia Red Cross has used this far also is the oral rehydration therapy preparedness at branch and community level, with the aim of immediate saving lives through case identification and oral rehydration therapy, and including self-referrals, as well as the branch transmission intervention teams, whose aim is to break the disease transmission routes in health facilities, case households, communities, and amongst the most vulnerable communities, households. We also have a role to play in the OCV campaigns through community mobilization and sensitization, given the fact that we do have a lot of volunteers that are easily trained and be able to assist with mobilizing the communities to enhance, to reach a wider coverage and ensure that the uptake of the vaccination is somewhat acceptable. So just to make mention a bit about the ORP concept that I did allude to as part of our strategy, which contain WASH as a critical component, is the ORP. In the analog here in the pictures, here it is where we are able through volunteers be able to identify and break routes of transmission by ensuring that people do have access to clean and safe water, and ensuring that this could be easily by easily treating household level water purification. But also the concept do have a component of being able to have early warning system, because volunteers are trained to be able to track cases of diarrhea at community level and be able to treat to signal the local facility. And there's also a critical component that will help reduce our caseloads or the workload at cholera treatment centers by ensuring that by erecting the ORP points within the communities, where cases before they get the treatment centers can easily be resuscitated, and ensuring the safe referral, and in such a way we'll be able to reduce the fatalities, which normally happen because people, by the time they get to treatment centers, they are totally dehydrated and they may not be resuscitated and recorded either as facility or indeed community death, depending on hours that they spent at the facility. So just to mention a bit about this, what has been done so far is that there have been trainings that have been done to volunteers and some Ministry of Health staff alike on the concept of ORP. And in the picture there you are seeing is And the picture that where you are seeing there, there's a, on the left, there's ORAP training happening, taking place in Mpulungu. And on your right, you're seeing the ORAP kits that have been pre-positioned in corridor hotspots, some in Lusaka, in Mpulungu up north, and in Sama up north as well. So about our strength on workforce, I've already mentioned about our volunteer network that are pre-positioned, as well the development of ORAP level one and level two training packages, which have already been done and in use, to be ready to be used in other countries. And 15 staff and 60 volunteers trained in ORAP points, which I've already mentioned. We have pre-positioned 28 ORAP kits, chlorine, soap, and hand washing facilities in the Korela hotspots. So we are doing it dual. Whilst we are doing the preventative role, we know that peradventure there could be an outbreak. We should be well prepared to ensure that we are able to respond in time, efficiently, and indeed effectively. So some achievements under Steel Wash through a project which we're implementing, but with the support of the CDC funding, we have piloted Wash and Korela hotspot assessment tools in Mpulungu and in Sama up north, the two selected Korela hotspots, which have already been mentioned by the other presenters. And also the feedback of each country from these tools which have been tested will help in the revision of the whole M&E2 with regards to ORAP and community sensitization. Then also there's a pending water treatment training at community level amongst the volunteers, selected volunteers in Mpulungu and in Sama up north. This is where at community level volunteers will be able to make chlorine, which they should be able to use to treat water at household level, just to help improve access to clean and safe water. As one of the key drivers of cholera outbreaks in these hotspots is the consumption of unsafe or contaminated water. We enhance their mobility to reach their communities widely. The volunteers have been supplied with bicycles, which they are going to use also during sensitization in their communities to help identify and break routes of transmission of cholera. But as Iron mentioned, that we are also taking a role in oral cholera vaccination. Recently, those numbers that have been presented by Dr. Kapaya, we played a role by deploying 210 volunteers in one of the hotspot districts in a community mobilization and sensitization to a level that we were able to reach about 19,000 households. And the outcome in this area is that they were able to vaccinate more than 92% of the target. So COVID brought its own challenge in many sectors, but would feel also that engineer Olanda mentioned that COVID itself had brought its own challenge. We realized that we can implement activities which have got dual protection, which can protect COVID, but at the same time protect against the transmission of cholera. So we distributed about 9,680 tablets of soap amongst the vulnerable people within the hotspot. We're also able to supply 148 hand washing facilities to health facilities, public places, with a belief that as we people are adopting hand hygiene, will not only protect against COVID, but also protect against cholera. The community sensitization, we went quite wide on this one with the public address system, with collaboration with Zambia National Information Service, where we're able to do remote campaign through public address, door-to-door sensitization on hygiene, including schools. And we ensured that the hotspots where we had presence were able to maximize this because we realized that we may receive the double benefit. Then we were also looking at access to clean water and supply. As the engineer Orlando mentioned, that there were boreholes that were rehabilitated, but definitely government cannot reach everywhere and cannot just do everything. So as partners, we're able to rehabilitate the three boreholes in Kapiriponshi and also in Bulungu, reaching to an estimated, benefiting to an estimated population of 48,633. So this was complementary to what the government was doing. We do realize that these boreholes that have been rehabilitated in these two hotspots, not only will they enhance hygiene to protect against COVID, but cholera as well. To ensure the sustainability of these boreholes, 34 area pump menders were trained in Bulungu and Kapiriponshi, and in collaboration with the local government, the Ministry of Local Government and Housing under the WASH sector, to ensure that when we are gone, they should be able to take on this repair and rehabilitation of the boreholes. So we also, just to make mention that we looked at also the need of the different abled people, and we were able to cater for them also to promote hygiene by supplying hand washing stations, which were user friendly to the paraplegic. So we also trained the champions, what we are calling the WASH champions, to continue sensitizing the communities and triggering communities on hand washing. Just as my colleague did mention, that we are looking at sustainable means of doing things. We are promoting simple but effective technology, the TP-Tap technology within the communities, as we may not manage to supply the hand washing facilities, the stations in all the communities. Where still, maybe their sustainability would be questionable, but such kind of simple but effective technology, we would be sure of their sustainability. Yes, so yeah, we're not doing all these things. We are not doing our work in isolation or in a silo. We are a critical partner to Minister of Health at all levels, and we do work together to ensure there's coordination with National Public Health Institute, Disaster Mitigation and Management and Mitigation Unit, UN agencies such as UNICEF, and within the Red Cross Society, we have our partner, our mother board, International Federation of Red Cross, also our partner in national societies such as the Netherlands Red Cross, and also our back donors such as the CDC, who have helped us to implement this the two projects, one in Bulungu and one in Nsumbu, which is in Nsama district. With that, I wish to thank you.